see. Now all of those chances prove not meant to be. She said, give me back the whispers that I fight the wind to hear. Give me back the labors, make me work for what I wear.
We are live. Hi everyone. I'm sharing the screen today with my good friend Olga. Oh, what happened? Oh, there. Okay, the screen changed. Yeah, so if you guys want to join in the chat on, I will see your chat on YouTube, Facebook, and on Twitch. And if Olga has it on her, where you are, or if you're watching on YouTube, you'll be able to see the chat visually as well. I didn't. Hi, Gina.
Is she talking?
Olga's talking. Can you not hear her?
No.
Oh.
Excuse me.
No, Marco said he can't hear you. Hang on, Gina. Don't leave us. We're figuring out glitches.
Yeah, you can entertain me.
I don't know. You can listen to her.
Can you hear me, though?
I can hear you. I just can't hear her.
Oops. We need that funky, like, waiting music.
I need to add audio. A new source audio input capture. There it is. See, I knew we were missing something. Where's your keyboard?
It's right there. He forgot to input your audio. See, some things you can't test until you are live.
Well, I'm sure there is a way to do it, but I'm just...
No, us. Not your fault, no.
Do you want me to unplug the headphones and we'll see if there is feedback for her?
Try, yeah. Let's see. Oh, here.
Hey, Olga, can you talk? There you go. Gina, can you hear her? Gina hears an echo. I don't know. Marco's just gone into the other room to see how he can hear it.
I can, from all the options that I have, I can mute and unmute.
Gina can't hear you. Okay. Hello. How can we add you in? We didn't even think of that because we thought through Discord it would be automatic that they could hear you.
I can be muted as well. You know, I'm just...
Just create?
That will be sounding new for me.
Poor Olga. Well, our...
Olga, inappropriate jokes.
Yeah. You're not going to get bleeped. Well, we're crazy that Marco is trying to fix it. We are actually working on we're doing the second part of our Dark Alice pieces that we both started a couple weeks ago on Olga's stream. So that is where I left off, and Olga left off with her little monster eye legs in her box for the falling Alice. Just gotta move some of my things around here. Okay. I'm working on the other side of my desk. She sounds far, far away. Yeah, Olga's falling down the rabbit hole, so she's very, very quiet. No, hopefully.
I'm really far, far away. Literally on the other side of the world.
Yeah, maybe that's why, right? You're in Germany and I'm in Canada.
Yeah, it will take you a few minutes to get through.
Little time delay.
We'll get it fixed. So yeah, I'm gonna add pastel work to my. I was thinking of doing some crackle paste too. I'm not sure.
Ooh, that's nice. But you can hear me, yes?
I can hear you.
Okay.
And they can just hear you coming through my monitor, but it's very, very faint.
I can also scream.
He is actually supposed to be working, so I don't know how much he can help us. This may be where we're at for this first time, this first run. I'm not sure. It sounds spooky, crazy, that says.
No, that's the beauty of live stream.
Oh, yeah. It's like, let's see what we can figure out on the fly. I know, I didn't know that your time change was different from ours. I thought we would do it at like the same time, the time zone switch.
You know, that seemed logical to me as well, but today I was chit-chatting on Zoom, on Crafty Meeting. We have them regularly, and I always schedule them for 7 p.m. my time.
Yeah.
So I scheduled like always, and girls were like, oh my god, why are we at earlier this week? And I was like, no, we are not. So that's how I get to that. We are not switching times at the same time. That would be logic, but.
Yes. I'm just, in case anyone new follows or that, I'm turning off the event and the notifications because my volume is cranked right now so we can hear Olga. And if I leave those on, we will all just be deafened by notifications. So in case you're wondering why, if it doesn't come up on the screen, that's why. Okay, time to create. Oh, you gessoed her legs?
Yes, I gessoed them. I wanted to leave them like they were, but then the wheel of the stripe, I have no idea how I will rehandle stripes, but oh well.
Yeah. Oh. They probably would have been easier before you put them in the box.
Probably, but you know, my concept keeps changing because I really think that, full concept will be here
like 2 days from now, and
you know, when Yes. Yeah, I ordered a tiny furniture to arrange the room, and we're actually growing out from the room.
Oh.
In the meantime, I figured out that I can assemble some teapots and some creepy tea party on the top. You know, like 10,000 ideas, but. Then, yeah, so.
I ordered tiny lights and they haven't come yet.
Excuse me.
Oh.
Maybe.
He's going to try something else.
Okay, I'm hoping that the sound issue is when we are streaming on your channel, not on mine, because I would be helpless. At least we have a tech support.
Pardon?
At least we have a tech support. If it yes. happened on my channel, we would be hopeless.
Oh, I know. We'd be trying to figure it out ourselves without any
tech knowledge. We can just break it a little bit more.
Oh!
Olga's a little quiet. Unless he's going to boost.
Okay.
Just boost her volume a bit. Yeah.
I'm maxed out.
Yeah. Hey, Olga, no more echoing, so that's good.
Yay!
Yeah. But I am going to try and boost your audio.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can.
I don't think you can.
Because it's already maxed out.
I can also speak louder, but then it will sound like I'm screaming.
Hey, there. Perfect. No. Well, it's not echoing, so.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Very excited about it.
That's right. So much yelling, you know. Okay, so there's no more echo, but it's, you can hear the sound.
Okay.
It's angry management audio.
Yeah, that's right. Let your aggressions out, everyone.
There you go. Time to yell.
All these people that are watching are going to be screaming in their own spaces to join in.
Okay, I'm going to go back to work.
Okay, thank you.
Just to let you know, when I started to scream, my cat evacuated from the room. Like, so now I'm understanding. I'm surprised that nobody else was disturbed in my flat, and I'm screaming quite loud, so I believe that they just assumed that.
Gina says it's not any different for her, but we're okay. You know, like my tech husband, he's gonna be like studying this now, like any of his off time, trying to figure out how to fix this for next time. It's like a challenge put forth.
Like ongoing challenge.
Yes. So maybe next time we do this, it should work. Pardon?
I'm the same. Every time when I do something and it will not work out as I want it, I will keep on trying, keep on doing until it will come out just exactly like I want it.
Yeah. I'm the same. You want to figure out why, and then so you can actually do it without worrying again.
You know, actually, I always assume that it's my fault.
Really?
Yeah, because, you know, if it's technology, probably you can blame me. Because
not this time.
I'm a very, very technologically challenged person. The same is with all kind of art. It's always my fault. It's always human issue. I don't know why I assume that painting assembled piece will be easier. It's not.
No.
It's not. It would be better to do all the paint job before, but well.
But then when you don't know exactly what you're doing, like you haven't figured it out yet, it's kind of hard to do those initial steps unless it's totally planned.
You know, I'm totally guilty for overthinking and over-conceptualizing everything, because I have a lot of ideas and I cannot never settle on one. I want to try them all, and I'm always trying to fit them all in one piece. That is not always a good solution.
That's why most of my streams I don't even know what I'm doing before I jump on. Because otherwise,
yeah,
I will overplan.
Because last time when I catch you live, you were streaming. You ran directly to your stream, and then I was doing some designs on the computer, and I was watching you in the background, and you were doing patterns back then, roses, and I found it, very relaxing. I still feel like I'm doing something, at least participating in something artsy, while doing less artsy and less exciting things.
Yeah, that was for the die cuts for the window page, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I used three different blues in there, Gina, so I could kind of blend them together. I'm still probably going to add some darker. Probably, I don't have a dark blue, so I'll probably have to use some black.
Yeah,
Or do you mean because we're both working in blue, myself and Olga? It's because we're both doing Alice from Alice in Wonderland.
Yeah, I wanted to do adult colors, but then my husband was like, yeah, you know, you have just half of the lady hanging from the bobs. If you will change the colors, nobody will know what you wanted to say. That was his artistic input in my art, but usually he's equally useful with everything.
Yeah, because unless someone, like, knew exactly why there was little furniture and everything in there, too, right?
Yeah, because if I would have, like, complete thing, then it would be a little bit more obvious. So, yeah, we'll have to wait. I think that this piece will come together in a lot of pages. But that's how my favorite one is. Coming to life, and they are usually the most time-consuming ones. And those are last parts of my favorite dolls, so yeah, I'm not putting almost any pressure on myself here. Almost.
Well, that's good. Yeah, I think I might do something with the mermaid one, because I have two mermaids, because one was supposed to be a gift, but then we never saw the person that the gift was for. So I have a spare Monster High mermaid.
She also had legs, or she just have a tail?
She has a tail.
She can be mermaid clown.
Yeah. Or turn her into one of the mermaids from Peter Pan or something. Make her brightly colored.
Or evil mermaid with sharp teeth.
Oh, yeah, with the nasty teeth, like in, what was it, the Pirates of the Caribbean movie? The mermaids were not pretty.
Yeah, they had, like, exactly. But, you know, I just like creepy things, and unfortunately October is coming to the end, and then
creeping
around will be not so welcomed anymore, so I'm enjoying every single one last bit that I can.
That's good. What are you doing on what are you doing on Halloween?
I don't know yet. I was thinking about live streams so people can join and tell us scary stories, of course, with makeups and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
We can't do too much. We can do a small treasure hunt with kids in the afternoon or early evening. But we planned something bigger and we have to size it down because of the restriction.
Yes.
Yeah, and there will be no fun for parents, because we were planning to finish off in the pub.
Oh,
and,
yes.
Yeah, so unfortunately, that will be not an option. So I don't know how many parents will be up for just kids having fun without a reward at you. I'm trying to fit in the frame, but I have such a delay on YouTube. It's more than 1 minute, I believe.
Oh, so you don't see right away that you're out? I really enjoyed it. I took a break. I went and I did. Do you know who James Burke is?
Yes,
of course. Oh, yeah, because, right. So I did his virtual voyage Tim Burton class, which was a lot of fun, and it was a good break away from Alice in Wonderland. So now I'm really looking forward to jumping right back into the book creation. Like, I don't know if she'll make it in the book. She might be at the back of the book. But yeah, so I've got all these ideas. I was awake like during the night thinking about this Mad Hatter page. It's going to be like this 3-page spread with a tutorial. It's the Mad Hatter's Hat Emporium.
I love how you're figuring out those pages that are, you know, like with the cutouts, the one that interact with each other. Oh my god, I absolutely love them. They almost make me feel like, yeah, I should try that.
You like this one then.
And then I'm thinking about, you know, how should I do it and how much work it will take. And I'm like, nah, I can do 4, you know, 4 pieces in that time easily. You know, create a little coffins that I can put around. On Thursday, our landlord is coming, so I hope I will finish this cooking.
It's all because it's what you're used to doing, right? That's why you can do that faster. Like, I'd probably take longer doing that.
And you know, even the concept of a journal, because you're thinking how to create your layers, but still keep them relatively flat, because otherwise, if they will be two-dimensional, then your book will be like not closing properly after two spreads.
That's what my friend Joanne's are like.
Yeah, so, and I don't like when my book starts to look like that. I have like 3 journals, you know.
She makes them thinner.
I cannot. I don't.
Well, no, she pulls out sections of the book, so there's less pages in there. And then when she does a thick page, she gets some kind of weight and puts it, like, when the page is done and dry, she weights down the book to help kind of squish it back together.
I will have to think about something because I really like, you know, like with James, I'm following him for such a long time, and every time when I watch something from him, I'm like, yeah, I have to try, and then like, oh no, not enough layers, but just painting, I'm not super good at painting. So no, it will look awful, I cannot do it, no, it's better to give up, it's better to not try.
Oh, please.
Yeah, because if I will try and fail, then I have to redo it.
But that's how you learn.
Yeah, but then I will spend like a couple of days on doing one spread. And I'm pretty confident that within a couple of days, I could at least finish the pieces that I started. And they are chilling on the shelf and waiting for the spare time. But I'm really proud of myself because I actually did Tim Holtz 4 or 5. I still didn't catch up with the candles.
That's good. I was trying to watch it today because I only caught the end of it. Do you have to use his papers to be part of that challenge, or just everything else has to be Tim Holtz?
No. It's just to be part of the challenge, you just have to be inspired by the live show. Nothing more, because those papers that he was using, he had only one color out, and probably they were sold out in the stores, because he started with, you know, telling everyone that those papers are coming.
Okay.
So I really like this paper, but I believe that you will have a good watercolor paper.
Because, like, I posted this one in his Tim Holtz Facebook group, but whoever runs it, if it's Mario or whoever, they deleted it because they said I didn't use all Tim Holtz product.
That's weird. From what I know, you don't have to use like all Tim Holtz product. Oh my god, I love it! I just see it on the screen. Oh my god, it's
She's getting darker.
It's so cool.
Thank you.
I don't think that it have to be like all his products. I'm pretty sure that to leave the posts in Addict, you have to name all the products that you use.
Yeah.
Preferably with those numbers that they use as the reference. I usually don't post there a lot because it takes so much time to write a Facebook post. Especially if I have to look for the product. So I just tag on Instagram and hope that he will see it. I'm not the best smart with social media, you know, again, technologically challenged. A new Facebook is not favoring people who are technologically challenged.
Well, ever since it switched mine to the new Facebook, it's hard. Like, my computer doesn't even want to run it. I was trying to look up my nephew today so I could message him, and it wouldn't even pull up his name.
Yeah, it's weird. You know, it's showing me posts from the group that I'm not a member of, but it doesn't show me the posts of the group that I am belonging to, so I don't know. In this case, it's the one of the few that I don't think that it's me issue, because I see that people struggle with it all the time. So yeah. But I don't think that Facebook will improve.
Well, they bought Instagram, so I think they're focusing a lot on Instagram right now.
Yeah, but Instagram also has some stupid features. Instead of something useful, you know, they adding like 10,000 of things that nobody asked for, and they cannot fix the issues that users had. So yeah, if you are not big, you don't have like millions of followers, they will not care.
Yeah.
The reminder that we're going live in 30 minutes.
Sorry about that. I didn't think to check about your time zone change.
But honestly, you know, I didn't thought about it as well. Because, first of all, you know, it would be logic that all the countries, because I know that some countries do not change their time at all.
Yes.
Areas in the world. But you would think that if times change, it will change at the same time everywhere.
That would make sense.
No. There is probably some kind of really fancy reason behind it.
Probably, because like I remember you mentioning the time change, and I was just thinking, oh yeah, well that's later in November.
Yeah, that's later in, but you know, I was sure that it's 1 week after Halloween. And Halloween is not here yet, so we still have time, and then no surprise. But it always surprised me, you know, time change always surprised me. General,
yes.
Time is really abstract idea for me. I always have not enough
A lot of places here, they're still trying to get them to like not do it anymore.
The time change?
Yes.
Because the time change has sense. You know, it has have some kind of scientific explanation behind it. It's caused by the moon phases and the world's spinning and stuff like that. But seriously, you know, nowadays they should change time, like, everywhere at the same time. I think that that would be really possible, but nope. That would, you know, that would be just so easy and so logical, so... Alice is getting more and more Tim Burton-y every time we look at the screen. And, you know, it's a compliment. I don't mean it in a bad way.
Yeah, no, it could be because I was doing that for 2 weeks, right? All the Tim Burton stuff.
Did you also make the whole photo session and all that shebang, or just the artsy part?
Did I do the what part?
Because James did a photo session with his husband.
Oh.
One, they got Beetlejuices, and the other one, oh my God, I have no idea who James was, but his husband was Freddie Mercury.
Oh, James was Elton John. It was so much fun. Yeah, no, I got I got dressed up for the Halloween party.
Who you are dressing as?
I used my costume from last week and or last year, and it was Peter Pan.
Ooh. I have no idea who I will be. I know that we have also small dress up on Friday, and I'm hoping that that will be not canceled because I'm already prepared to be a vampire.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like not slutty one. I mean, maybe a little bit, but more into the creepy side, of course. Yeah, but if that one will not work out, then I will save it for Halloween. But in general, I'm more about makeup dress up than dress up. My favorite is the skull face. And I can see it whole Halloween and just paint my face to look like a skull face. And probably my husband will have to help me with shading and making it symmetrical. Because every time I fail in that department.
Hi, Joanne. So Joanne's on now, the one I was talking about that makes her journals really thick but pulls out pages to do so.
Yeah, but then she's flapping them.
Then she squishes them with a weight. Last year we did a round robin journal. We made our journals, and it was Alice like going on different adventures. It was the other adventures of Alice, these crossovers. But every time we met up, we traded journals. So we were always, every third trade, we'd work in our own journal for the prompt. But we were all working in each other's, and it was so funny. When Joanne would bring ours, we would know that the chances were it was going to be a thick page. So we would tease her.
So every time when it was her turn, then for a week you have to sit on your journal.
Yeah, she would wait it before she gave it back to us.
Oh, that's kind. That's kind of thoughtful.
Gina says she's thinking of buying acrylic paint. She sees on your desk that you have Amsterdam.
I really, really, really like Amsterdam. It depends for what do you want to buy them. How do you want to use them? But Amsterdam will work in both, like, artsy-fartsy outer art and in fine art, so that would be the most universal one to go. I also love Prima in pastel paint, but they are not meant to be like fine art paint.
No, I got some of those. I didn't really care. Like, but then I'm mostly working in journals, right? So it's different surfaces.
You know, for me, it's just amazing that they have exactly the same coverage on black and white surface. So if I have teeth that I can underpaint for shading and then do some dry brushing, it will look fabulous after first coat.
Well, that's good.
And I can cover all my boo-boos really easily.
What boo-boos? They don't exist. Yeah, so Gina, it depends on if you're doing it in a journal. I don't use my Amsterdams in a journal anymore. I use the Paper Artsy paint, but Paper Artsy costs a bit more. But if you're going to use something that has like a plasticky kind of shiny surface like Amsterdam would, you need to seal your pages with a matte varnish before you close your book.
You can always go for some kind of chalk paint, but they always, it depends on your colors. In your case, when you like a lot of vibrant colors, that might not work out because chalk paints always have this dullness to them. They always have this like white cast, chalky finish. So yeah.
Yeah, I liked our round robin, Joanne. Yeah, the Paper Artsy, their fresco finish chalk paints, they have a huge variety of colors. But even on that, I usually layer on top with either oil pastels or like Derwent Ink Tints or Caran d'Ache Neo Color 2s to get brightness back. But they actually have quite a few bright ones now.
From bright colors, I own only neon pink. And
really?
That's all. Yeah, I struggled with finding blues. Don't reach for the bright colors like at all. The most of our paints are all shades of browns, blacks, and sometimes cream.
Well, because you do a lot of the vintage type looking stuff, right?
Yeah, because I really like this like retro weird vibe.
Yeah.
So for most of the time, I'm using them either to make shading or to art for aging to items. So browns will be my go-to, and too much colors can.
Yeah. Or I love color, but then I like to darken up the edges.
You know, it's hard for me to use more than three colors on the. Like, I was doing those backgrounds, so I just followed Team Caleb. And I still don't know if I really, really love it, because it's so bright. On the other hand, you know, he cannot be wrong, so. I'm huge fan.
Yeah?
Really, seriously, huge. Yeah. I love his product, first of all, and second of all, I like the. You know, when you go to watch him live or you're watching the replay, he has this really cool vibe into him.
Yeah, he's got a good personality for it.
Yeah, you know, like, freak your freak. Yeah, so he, you know, the master cannot be wrong, so said that it will work out, and this week we will do something from it. So yeah, I have mine ready, and I'm ready for the next week.
Oh, okay. I was going to do something different. I wasn't thinking of prepping for Saturday, but I guess that's a good thing to do. Yeah, because he did say he's going to use them.
Yeah, so I hope that I would be able to like prep along to watch and do. That would be cool. I somehow missed the first one when he was doing the candles and he gave the list, the track list. I didn't interfering.
Interferes with your creativity.
Yeah, exactly. And oh my god, you would not believe how often it happens. Now we are switching for my favorite brand. We have to try a few more less. And I will start to make her look a little bit more curly.
I don't know if the green's taken her too far, but I'm playing.
Green is my least favorite color from whole rainbow, especially really vivid, bright green. Yeah.
I used to not like yellow. Oh, I know. Like, even years ago when we got married, on the black and white photos we had, the photographer hand-tinted some, and we had gold balloons in the wedding decor, but that was it. But he hand-tinted my bouquet yellow. And for so many years, I hated that photo, because I had no yellow flowers. But now I appreciate it. But it's like, where did he get yellow from?
But for the wedding bouquet, they say that yellow flowers you give people that you are jealous about. So
you think the photographer was jealous?
I don't know. Maybe there was a hidden message and you just missed it.
That poor man. I think that's why I put green on her. She's kind of like a zombie Alice. I have another zombie Alice, actually.
Yeah, but she was Team Bartini vibes, so...
I need to put it darker around her eyes to make it more Tim Burton.
Yeah,
she looks a bit sick, Gina says. Oh, Joette...
That was the vibe that you were going for.
Yeah. Joanne says she sees a face in your blue paint puddle.
Where?
I think in the dark blue. I can see like a eyeglass frame or something. I don't know if that's what Joanne's seeing.
I'm trying to see the face as well. No, I don't see it.
You don't see it?
Oh my god. Wait, I will. Matt!
Adding silver to her face. Oh, go away. Adobe Flash wants to keep updating. You're not odd, Joanne. You're wonderful. Actually, we're all odd, so. But you're wonderful. How are you? I didn't even get, because of the dual stream, I didn't get to ask anyone today. We had too many technical glitches. Do I don't have any clean fingers. Oh, Alice, what have you done? Maybe she needs like a pattern behind her or something. Some polka dots for Alice. We'll have to do a video art session again, Joanne. A private one. I don't know if you'd want to go public. Be cool if you did. But I would not pressure you. She must have had to step out for her kiddo. Or did she freeze? Did we lose her? Because I see her heat gun. Oh no. Did I lose her? We lost her. I thought because I heard her talking to family. Lost Olga. I'm gonna try and bring her back. Yeah, private is good. Come on, Olga, come back. I'm trying. Technical difficulties. Technical difficulties. I'm trying to get her back. Hang on. Let's see what we can do here. It's trying. It says it's trying to reach her. It says video connected. Olga! I'll let you guys look at my Alice while I try and get her back, okay? You can see it, huh? You can see it moving. Poor Olga. She's just creating a way, waiting for me to try and get her back. I don't want to bug my techie husband because he's at work. I'm going to go see if he's on a call maybe and see if he can help. Oh, I think he knows. He knows. Nothing. She was talking to like a family member or something that came in the room, and then I thought she just left her desk to go speak to them, but no, she's gone. I'm trying to get...
Like gone?
She's still working.
Oh.
Like she says she's working away, waiting for me to bring her back in.
Oh, let's
but
go
I
back
can't
to...
get her back in.
Oh, it's still loading.
Yeah, I think it's my Wi-Fi.
No,
right?
Your Wi-Fi's. I think you have to.
What do I have
disconnect
to do?
And reconnect.
How do I disconnect her?
No, no, you.
That I yeah. disconnect.
Yeah, because well, no, actually, she might have to. Olga, if you can hear us, you have to. Disconnect and reconnect. Oh, okay.
Oh, she can hear us.
Oh, weird. Okay, yeah, you're. Discord's not coming through. Can you try disconnecting and reconnecting in Discord? Please? something's going wrong.
That's weird that she can still hear us. Da, 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 da.
Yeah, it happens. That happens.
Hang on, guys.
So now she'll reconnect and then... Oh, there we go.
Oh, it switched again.
Yeah, I know. There's nothing you can do about it. And then I think you have to turn your audio and video on again. There we are. So let's go back to... Streamlabs, I think you're cooking. There
Yay!
We go. Hey, all right.
Thank you. You are back, my friend. Can you talk? Are you talking? I can't hear you. I know, it's all the spooky Halloweenness. Let's see, I'm just gonna see my chat with her to see if she says she can. She is talking. She's just gonna dry brush her project. And you have your audio turned on? I can see your brush moving. Oh, this is so bizarre. Okay, well, Olga's still with us, guys. And my volume is all the way up. And it's on. What does it say? Something my audio is on? Guest streamer. That's so weird. Okay. I can't hear her. Joanne says Marco to the rescue. She's writing signs and putting them in front of the camera.
What's going on?
I don't know. I scrolled down and the Discord went off, which we had before.
Hmm.
If I click on her, does it show anything?
No, you can't. Huh, weird.
She's been silenced.
Oh, that's not good. Yeah, you can only.
I can only do
mute
mine.
Yourself.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't hear her at all. Oh. Oh, okay. I think. Can we hear you? Can you try talking, Olga?
I didn't hear anything.
I didn't hear anything. If you're talking, sorry, can't hear you.
She's probably writing a note.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Something's up with the audio.
Yes. I am talking. Oh. Oh, no.
Oh, this is a drag.
Okay, I think we're going to have to try your program next time.
Yeah.
Yes. Joanne likes the talking cards.
Oh, well. Yeah. I don't know.
Oh, she's texting.
I don't know what's going on.
Sorry, Olga.
I mean, I suppose you could have her talk through the... What is it? Come on. Yeah. No reasons.
I don't know why I'm doing that.
Yeah, we could...
She's laughing. As long as she's having fun.
Well, if you're having fun. Do you have Discord on your phone? I was going to say that's another way to do it, but you don't.
No, it'll be on the iPad.
Okay.
Okay. Gina's laughing. He's now getting the iPad to see if we can get your audio through the iPad. This is so bizarre. You think it I don't know. Like, I'm on a Mac computer, and all of these programs are just in their beta versions for Mac, but they have, like, the full proper programs for PC users. He's got the iPad. And Crazy Bat's a PC guy, so... Trying to figure out things on a Mac is a little different.
It's just computers.
They're just computers. These computers.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Log in. God damn it.
Don't swear.
Gosh darn it. I need your Discord login. Don't say it.
I'll say it out loud. This is my login.
Yeah, see, I don't what? See... the audio coming through, right? Usually the green circle appears around.
Oh.
Yeah, there's something, I think, muted on your side, Olga. I'm not blaming anyone. But in just... Oh, no, I saw something now. There was a brief moment of audio. Here, let me check.
I'm trying to find where it is first. What am I using? This? These are oil pastels. This is a blending stump.
Blending stump.
Right there.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a blending stump. I'm trying to get used to it. I still prefer my fingers. And then these are oil pastels. So it will need to dry for quite a while before I... Let my journal be all alone without any deli paper in between the pages for protection. These were my birthday gift to myself this year.
Happy birthday to me.
Happy birthday to me.
All right.
It might have a time delay on the iPad, though, right, for the audio?
Yeah, but it's just to hear if...
But at least we can hear if it works.
So is Olga talking right now?
Olga, can you try talking? She's probably been talking this whole time.
Probably.
Oh, that little circle showed up.
Yeah.
It's coming and going on here.
That means the audio... Oh, yeah, okay.
But I'm not hearing anything even on the iPad.
Either. Oh, this one... is a China marker.
Oh, it was on mute and now it's... Oh, I see. Yeah.
Olga's trying mute on and off. We're just not getting anything.
Oh, she's on a PC. She's trying all the buttons. Well, a minute ago, your little circle came up showing your audio was on. It's gone again now.
This is really strange.
Yeah, this is a China marker. I was trying to find my other one that's traditional China marker, but I couldn't find it. But this one is pretty much the same thing. Waterproof, permanent. What was that? I heard something. Oh, her little circle's on again. It is a spirit of Halloween. Jeez, the mute family is prowling the net, Joanne says. Your circle's gone again. Olga's being like, I'm not going to stream with her again.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I know. It's not your fault. We're trying something new. It's good to try something new.
I'm not going to stream with her again.
That's the problem. You're going to hear me delayed.
It's not your fault. We're trying something new.
Oh, Ramona, that was like... Oh, God. Ramona, that was filmed in 2006.
That's the problem. You're going to hear me delayed.
Oh, it's like feedback upon feedback.
It's going to tunnel it. Oh, shoot. Don't do that. It's not good. Feedback. Turn the volume off.
We're going to just... Yeah, there's something
more. Ramona says that she just saw my video from when I was on HGTV for That's Clever.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, it was filmed in 2006 in the summer, and it aired 2007.
So, next time we'll get the technical stuff worked out. I apologize.
The tech guy's apologizing.
Yeah, but I have to go back to work now.
Gina's enjoying it. Okay, go do your work. There is another option for next time, because when I went on... to see that it was working on Facebook and Joanne was on there, a thing popped up saying, do you want to invite Joanne to the video? So I don't know if I could pull like Olga in through the video that way. But then that wouldn't be on YouTube and stuff. It would only be Facebook. Oh, it's a mind bend. It's looking good, Olga. Your Alice falling. I'm just going to sit here and talk to myself. What did you mess up, Joanne? No, you didn't mess anything up. No. I'm just saying, no, I didn't touch it. It was just I think with the upgrade of Facebook... You can now do things like that. That was the first time I'd seen that. Yeah, thanks, Marco. Thanks for trying. That dress is turning out cool. Looking at Olga's work. Yeah, my other China marker, I have it. It must be in my other bag because I actually sharpened it to a point. And that's what I was looking for to use in this, but I cannot see it, so I'm making do with this stubby one. It's just because I used oil pastels, I know I can't go in with, like, my my pocket brush, Pantel pocket brush to the lines, because it won't really stick in those areas. It will after the oils are totally dry, like in a few days, but this is giving me some definition. Yeah, I can't wait to see Olga's when it's done. She's going to have to post it online once she gets the little furniture pieces that are due to arrive and adds them in. So those will be awesome. Add some gold and copper to Alice's hair. It's so funny, we actually did, if you guys think we're just trying this live stream today for the first time, we actually did a test run on the weekend, but we didn't go live. And everything worked in our test run. But now that it's live, there's a few other glitches, it seems, that we have to work through. So I'm getting updates via a text from Olga. So hers will have to dry. You oversprayed on at some point? Oh, okay. I will run and we'll try again next time. Oh, okay. Okay, so you're going to go for now, Olga? That's a yes? Okay. I can totally see you saying, I'm sorry, we're going to do this again. Yes, we'll plan another one, and she's happy. I'm glad we tried. We're going to try again. We'll do some more research. I might have to use a different program next time when it's my turn to host. So, thank you, Olga. We'll chat again later tomorrow. We'll chat tomorrow, okay? See you soon. Bye. I'll stay on, you guys. I'm going to... Oh, she's moving the camera around. I'm looking to see how Marco brought her in, because then I can take it off. I think it's there. She's trying to show us up close, I guess. Okay. Safari, there it is. Oh, poor Olga. We tried. I want to do this because it's so much fun when we get to, like, interact and hang out with different people and see different art styles and have some fun. So, yeah. On YouTube, I put all of her links. I'm just going to put them here in the chat so you guys can see them if you want to go check out her stuff later. But she's a lot of fun. Paste. Okay, so there's her links. So everything's pretty much just her name. She doesn't have her YouTube channel as her name, but If you Google her name on Google, if you search her name on YouTube, you'll find her channel. But yeah. So she... It was fun, but hopefully next time we won't have any glitches, because I'd really like to do a lot of that and do it with other people as well. Bring more people in. I don't know, is this Alice done? Should we do something new? We could do something new. I have a tea here somewhere. Oh, there we go. Poor Olga. My tea is stone cold. Alice, are you done? She's almost done. So I'm just going to finish this one up and then we can do something else. Maybe I'll define her nose bridge a bit more. What are you guys doing while we're creating? I hope you enjoyed that I brought someone else in. I think you did. A tooth necklace? What, for Alice, or is that what you're working on? Oh yeah, I do have to darken more around her eyes, don't I? Something new? Okay. I'll just finish up this part and around her eyes. And then we can start on something a little different. But yeah, when Olga and I were talking about doing a stream, she's like, can we do something dark? She goes, most people don't want to do something dark. So I was like, sure, we can do Dark Alice. I suggested Dark Alice. I said, or we can do something non-Alice. But she agreed. She liked the idea of a Dark Alice. Because hardly anyone ever does a Dark Alice. It's usually Pretty Alice. They're so pretty. Yeah, you like that, Gina? Oh, she looks like she saves teeth. In James's class, the Tim Burton one, we were doing lots of tiny teeth creatures. Hello, Exora. How are you today? Have you been watching for a while, or did you just pop on? So I did have another artist on with me, but we lost her audio, so she has left the stream for today. And we're going to try again another day. It was really good. I think I liked it more than Virtual Voyage 1. I don't know. I really enjoyed it, but maybe it's because I really needed a break. It was like a vacation. It was like a virtual vacation for me, art-wise. Not in other ways, but art-wise, yes. Kind of thinking I might like to try and do something like that around February or... No, I just have some ideas in my head. For an online art retreat. Because we used to do them in person. He's doing the free Merry Mix Media again, which is coming up soon for like Christmassy stuff. I think she's good. Do we need some lower lashes or no? I don't know. I think she's good. I'm looking at Alice. Man, she's a creepy one. She said, Olga says she's going to post a picture of her finished piece once she gets the pieces done. So watch her Instagram, okay? She might still be watching right now, I don't know. Oh, Alice. Alice is doing her Instagram photo here. Did I close my messenger? Nope. There we go. My phone's not been staying on Wi-Fi a lot lately, and it keeps going off the network and then using up all my data. So I have to make sure I close everything. There's our Tori Spelling. Unplanned Tori Spelling Alice. She's more than good, thank you. Oh my goodness gracious me. Okay, let's put the pastels away. Let's play with something different. Sorry, I'm trying to keep them in color families. And I was trying to keep most of my sennelier in one container. We do. Put my water back over here. Did you guys want to see what I did in James's class first? Do you want a little flip through? I haven't. What do you mean you can't hear me? Oh, you should be able to. My mic's working. Joanne. My mic's working. I could probably close Discord now, actually. Because I don't need that open. Can you hear me now? Can you guys hear me? Can you hear me? Crazy that I can hear me. Okay, and Jen can, and Gina can. This is you, Joanne! Did you turn your volume off? Just you. Here's my Lydia Dietz. So not all of this was from the class, but it's just Tim Burton-y stuff. I put the fuzz stuff on here. The flock. That's what it's called, right? Flock? Fuzzy flock? Fuzzy fun flock. On the balloon, so it's all fuzzy. It's like a fleece. This was in class. This was one of my favorites that we did. It was not a live class, it was a pre-record, and I actually haven't watched, I only watched the first out of three segments, so I still have to watch the other two segments, but I was kind of going by what I'd seen other people do. This was a live class. This was a live class, and I have not finished it. He was using boxes and vases, and I thought to make it into, like, a coffin, but I still need to figure out my shape, because the shape's not quite right. That was not a live class, but it was a class. This was a fun class. This was alive. So much fun. I did my eyes totally different on the big piece from what we'd been doing in the practice ones. And then this was a class that we did. It wasn't live, but he had it in the classroom. He had it where you used his image of a girl and then created all these, like, Edward Scissorhand topiary hairdos on them, but it was always the same character of his, but I did my own characters. Thanks. This was a class. I haven't finished my tree yet. By the way I did it, I did see, you can see the little pumpkin. This was our last class. Like, these two were our last live class. And then there's still more. I haven't done them all because he put a lot into it for 2 weeks. Like, there was a lot. So I still have more to do, but yeah. It was fun. And the cover I just did myself. We didn't do covers in the classes. But it was good. It was good. Now we have a blank page staring at us. Like, where did I put my pencil? Oh, there it is. There you are, Peter. I guess I could put the alerts back on now, can I? Oh, I did chop off the tip when I closed my tin. Alerts and events. Okay. There's Exora. Okay. Okie dokie. So the next one I want to do for the book is like when I did the wig emporium in your journal, Joanne. But it's gonna be a hat emporium, and I was planning it out. My bag's in the other room with my initial sketches. It's a Mad Hatter hat emporium. It's going to be actually 4 pages. Because this is going to be the storefront with the window. This will be the store across the street. Because you'll view it when you're inside the Hat Emporium. This is the Hat Emporium. Through that window, you will see a character. I'm not sure if it's going to be the Mad Hatter as a salesman, or if it's going to be someone that's in there purchasing, because then they can try on the different hats. Do I do a trial run of it today? I don't know. No, I'll do something else. See, I'm like, I wasn't planning on doing my own thing until like half an hour from now. So now I'm like, okay, what should I do now? Why don't we just do some easy breezy stuff? Let's do some easy breezy. And I'll save my intensive for off the live, because I want to save that out as a class that goes with the book. My apologies, and not publish it until the book is out. I'm gonna grab a pen. Let's do, since I labeled this stream as Spooktober, let's do some Halloween-y type characters. I guess I'll do Halloween-y Alice characters. Wonderland characters, because I'm in the Alice book. I was going to grab a different book, but no. Let's do... We do the Tweedles. The Tweedles. Need a clip. And like I've moved things around. Oh, my clips are over there still. I'm still putting my room back together, so it's a little chaotic still. Let's do some Tweedles. So they're twins, right? Oh, what was the... That was the best one? Yeah, I'm gonna have to borrow your book to be able to show it properly, right? Because mine, I just have a printout. It's not interactive. It's just a copy. Yeah. When I can see you again, I'll have to borrow it to show on the stream. Okay. Tweedles. Two chubby Tweedles. Tweedles. Yay! I'm gonna make them Tim Burton-y Tweedles. Are Halloween-y Tweedles. I should give it like little bat ears. Halloween-y Tweedle hats. Tweedledee and Tweedledum. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. What kind of bodies do they want? Give them their I was going to make them into overalls, but I think I still kind of will. Splooking. Make it like his hand's actually in a pocket, another pocket. Give him another pocket. You're gonna go to sleep? Okay. Bye, Gina. Sweet dreams. Like when their shirt starts. I should do a buckle. She's just doing like little shoes here. These little plump dudes. With his feet. What I didn't do is a little pumpkin. Should they have the same pumpkin or something different? No, I haven't been hanging out with James Burke for 2 weeks. James Burke and Tim Burton. No, not at all. What else could he have? We already have bats on their heads, so I don't want to put a bat in the pocket. It has to be something that, even when it's small, is distinguishable. Something Halloween-y. No ears. Candy corn? You can have a piece of candy corn. A piece of candy corn. There you go. There we go, little overalls. Little overalls. I need to use my Prima paint. Oh, there they are.
taken my swatch out of here, and it was over here. That's why I'm looking over there to see if I can see it. But obviously, I moved it aside during today's thing. I do them pastel-y with, like, darkness. It's kind of my thought. Spray bottle. Mm-hmm. Spray bottle, there it is. I do want my moon glow around the eyes. It seems so strange not having Olga in here now. Don't be flash, you're becoming extinct. Stop asking for updates. Yeah, so I really want to make them like pastel and a little different, and then some darkness over top. Thank you, Joanne. No, I didn't do the other arm. Huh? Oh, I should have put the moon glow on the bats. The bats. It's Halloween-y. Should I give them like green overalls or kind of like Christmassy? I could do orange. I could do, because I have to do their hats as well. I want to put a little bit of blue in the face, like that one. The light teal. Oh, I do the orange in there. I can put the orange in their pumpkin and candy corn and then their hats. I think the bottom is the orange. Okay, so maybe not so pastel-y. I just grabbed the wrong blue. That's okay. I'll pretend he's lighter on this side. It's where the light is hitting him. Oh, Harley. My red is still wet, so I'm trying not to look at any of the water touching the red. I have to do someone else on the other side. Will they dry? Because I put a lot of water on there. I could do the grass. I could do the ground.
Snagglepuss. I have to do the lighter blue in the pocket, but I'm not going to do it yet. Not yet. Who else can we draw? This lady that was in the class called Desiree, she did the coolest Red Queen. Is how the Red Queen always says off with her head, and then I wish I'd come up with the idea. There were like these scissors in the Red Queen, but the scissors were like handles were here and it was showing open like around her neck, and then there was like a dotted line and it said off with her head. It wasn't gruesome at all. It was like cutesy. It was brilliant. Right, Gypsy? Her whole book is like amazing. She did a flip through on Instagram. It is so cool. I'm like, darn it. Oh, maybe she had a lot of time those 2 weeks. Holy cow. But her talent is, yeah. She's mighty cool. Her spiral, though, reminded me of my other Alice journal that's, like, towards my tutorial book. This one. When she opens her cover and you see her Tim Burton and he's on the spiral, it reminded me of this. So this is one of my Alice ones. Alice. And she spins. I'm like, oh man, great minds think alike. Sorry, my light's really washing her out. She's not that dark. Or not that white, I should say. Bright white. But yeah. Her journal was phenomenal. I still have to do my In Emergency Open Your Door page. And I have a good idea for that. It's just going to take some time. You drooled over it? Yeah, totally. Even James was like, oh my gosh.
I was hoping she lived closer. I messaged her and I asked her where in Canada she lived. And she no longer lives in this province, but apparently she used to just live like within a half hour drive of where I am. So she was really close. I keep looking at my Miss Mindy Alice, or Red Queen. So I'm trying to think. Oh, I pulled out my nose piercing. Trying to think of how I want to do her. I know! It would have been so much fun. Especially if the weather was still good and we could, like, meet out in the park or something. That would have been cool. Doop, 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 doop. Skinny arms. Does that give you Red Queen kind of vibes? She's gonna need some more hearts on her. Color tie-in. I keep pulling out my watercolor stick of the moon glow because I don't have my palette out that has the moon glow in it. And I kind of want them to be moon glowy. Moon glowy? Like she needs a little bit of help.
think James has interfered my artwork for a while. That and the Tim Burton book, because I find almost every night I'm sitting there and I'm going through the book. Because it's really cool. It's very expensive, but it's really cool. Yeah, it's good. Where's my other one? Sorry, I saw my other one the other day, so I pulled it out. This one my husband had gotten me a few years ago. Ugh. This is one of the ones my husband had gotten me a few years ago. Oh, it got paint on it. Look at that. So even this one's really good for reference. There's not as many pictures though, it's more about Tim. But there's still quite a few of them in here. And then I have one of the coloring books, like the official coloring book somewhere. I haven't colored in it, I just got it for the visual inspiration. I got that one a few years ago too. Look, the pages are yellowing. I don't know when I got this. It was a long time ago. I want to do a totem. But yeah, quite a bit's in there. Information. Oh, artist statement. Did they put it in the back then? You know how they usually do the publication information? Oh, this was from the art gallery, the MoMA. The Museum of Modern Art in New York. There we go. When was this printed? 2009. 2009 by the Museum of Modern Art in New York. Yeah, search that one out. It might be a nice cheaper option. The other one too, you know how James was getting like cat hair on the cover because it's fabric of the big book? And I thought, oh James, like that's horrible. Mine, just from handling it, it's getting like dust and stuff. Like you need a lint roller for that book cover. I don't know what color background to give her. Or what color hair. It's a high maintenance book. Yes, it is. It is one you're going to have to take care of. Yeah, I was quite surprised. It's heavy too. It is a big book. My collars never looked that great. I always struggle with my clown collars. I probably should have done them opposite. Dark at the top. I I didn't curve it enough really either, but that's okay. Oh yes. There we go. Get some black. Oh, yes. Absolutely. Yeah, that'll make a difference in it for the shading. Oh my gosh, look how dark her eyes are. I think the boys need a little bit of that. I'm gonna do more pen around the eyes too, but these two look more like Tweedledee and Tweedledum than my two-headed Stefan from SNL version. I still like that one though, that one's pretty cool. This guy looks like he's crying black. What color hair should we give the Red Queen? Thank you. We should do like a shocking orange, go kind of traditional, Tim Burton traditional. I really thought I was going to do my Mad Hatter's Emporium today. Yeah, I kind of have to go with what you're feeling. But I do need to get that those pages done for the book. I have now subscribed to Adobe, so I can start doing all the digital work for the layout, all the graphics work.
for the book. Oh my gosh, look at her. She needs like some crazy tendrils of hair. Crazy hair. The Red Queen is a mess. She's kind of like I can't see her. I have a Red Queen pillow I did years ago that has black hair, and I did this to her black hair. And it just added this extra, like, something to her. It's one of my favorite pieces. My light flickering. It's like I do have stream ghosts today or something. Muting Olga. Oh, orange ran into her head. It's my circle light that I just bought. It's flickering. It's a good thing we still have the box, I guess. Okay. Now her dress. I think I'm gonna give her some regal purple. I think this is a purple. Yes. Don't you know who I am? I'm the queen. Ooh, if I had purple flock, that'd be cool. So then her dress could be fuzzy. I think I'm going to do yellow around these red hearts on our poofy sleeves and then make them gold. But I'm going to pull out one of my other golds. This is my Cheshire Cat. This is one of the stickers that's going to come out with the book. And then I'll put the extras in my Etsy afterwards. Gold. I like gold paint. Okay, so yellow. I knew it. I'm like, don't touch any area that might be wet. And that's the first thing I did. You always get nervous around the red? Well, yeah, because depending how you use it too, like, I've done it where I thought, oh, it'd be cool to write that in red, and then you do it or do, like, the splattering, and it's like, oh, no, no, that just looks very wrong. So I avoid red for those things. That's not a good fit. Should we put some neon in her crown first? A little brightness. Just a wee bit of neon. No, it's not forgiving. Like, that little splotch is still there in the yellow. And gold. I think I will use Schminky. I have this one that's a bit more coppery. Like antique gold. That's Daniel Smith. I have this one that's Schminky gold. I think this is the one I have in like all my palettes. Yeah, my iridescent gold. I also have this one I mixed glitter into, but that's an ochre I put glitter into. I could do a bit of both actually. Both of these two. Shading, I can use the darker one. And the spot so I can use the lighter one. I think the boys are ready for some rosy cheeks in a minute. Didn't even color her arms. I'll give her like stripy arms or something. Yeah, it does. And then it'll shimmer too, like when it's dry and I move the page.
page is bending a bit, so my shadows for the arms are not going to stay where I want them to. I love her hair. Okay, boys, you need some pink on your cheeks. Maybe a little blue around your eyes. Oh, he's still wet. I'm gonna do this one. A little fluorescent on the cheeks. Oh, I need to do the yellow of the candy corn. Sorry, I always do big size, like when I'm trying to figure something out. It's too red. What's this one? That's almost the same. I want sepia. So is this a sepia? Nope. I have to open my other palette. Sepia is like my go-to when I'm shading faces. A little hair came off the brush. You knew. That's gonna leave a mark. Work it in. God, she looks weird. Definitely not a pretty red queen. Oh, I need to do their buckles. jewel will have to be a color too. Pretty is overrated. Let's get a darker purple since the other palette's out now. You're still wet from the other day. Yeah, here's some blue around her eyes. Let's use some Sleeping Beauty. She needs some eyeshadow, some lovely blue eyeshadow. Now when you hear you're having a visitor like Tim Burton come by, you have to doll yourself up. All the way up to the eyebrows. Oh my goodness gracious me. I think I can get yellow on their, or gold on their belt buckles now. Let's see. LaShonda, did you cheer? Oh, I didn't put my... I put the alerts back on, but I didn't put the other stuff on. So we didn't get to see if it fell in or not. No tip jar's there. Oh, it's right there. Oh, I see it in there. I didn't see anything happen on the screen, though. Safari, Discord, events. Alerts and events are on. I had them off earlier.
heat gun. That's weird, it didn't show. But we've had a lot of weird things happening today. There it is, and that scared the heck out of me. My volume was up full blast because I was sharing my screen with someone today at the beginning of this video, and her audio wouldn't work, so we had... So we had the volume cranked. I forgot to turn it down. And now Nightbot's taken away your comment. Thank you for the donation and the cheer, LaShonda. I highly appreciate it. Hello, how are you today? Yeah, I started at 12 today because I was doing two streams. So first I brought in Olga, who lives in Russia. And we were sharing a screen, but then it just, her audio stopped working. And so she went off to do her work all on her lonesome. And then she's going to post the final piece after. But I didn't stop the stream and start again. I just kept going from where I was. So I think I finished my Creepy Alice, which is on the last page. And then now we're, since the stream's called Spooktober, I thought we'd do some Tim Burton-y Alice in Wonderland characters. But yeah, we're figuring out how to have guest artists on the stream. That is what we're figuring out. We just had a few glitches today. Because we did a test run on the weekend and it all worked really well, but we didn't go live. So different things happen when you actually go live. So we are learning. Oh, I kind of like her with a blue eyeshadow. Oh my gosh. Put some neon blue in there too. Do not run, do not run, do not run. Do not run. Come on, guys. Jeez. Oh, look at that. That's better. That's better. I think I need to darken up the shadow side of her crown a bit more. And the underside of her hair. That eyeshadow was running amok. I think I'm going to have to post this one in the Berkmates Facebook page and say, you've invaded my brain. You've taken over. She almost looks like a Red Queen Nutcracker. I think it's because of her frilly top frills there. Dark red. James Burke and Tim Burton have taken over my brain. Oh, Adobe, go away. Hot flush. Let's drink my cold tea. Yeah, I definitely think I have to share it on James's page. So look what you have done to me. Oh man, she's gonna need like mega eyelashes and everything. Her eyeshadow is like bleeding all over her head. She's like Mimi from the Drew Carey show. Same with that blush. Hola. So much blush. I know, right, Gypsy? We're all gonna be stuck in like Tim Burton land. It's almost like it when he had us do the swatches, it almost is like he took us and put Mindy Lacefield and Tim Burton together. Like, not so much James Burke, but like for the faces, I mean, like the round faces with the eyes low down, it's like Mindy Lacefield and Tim Burton. Her eyes are a little higher than the Tweedles. Hi, Susan. You're late, late, late. Oh, you are. You're almost an hour late. Thank you for liking the stream. I started early because I was doing that other guest stream before this. So I've actually been on here for 3 hours. Gotten quite a bit done in 3 hours. My water is very dirty though. Even my clean one's getting kind of dirty. How are you, Susan? Diana said she was going to try and remember to pop in today, but I haven't seen her yet. And LaShonda is here. And Joanne was here too. Regulars. They're probably just lurking. I can't believe it's already almost Halloween. This month, this whole time at home seems to be flying by. I want them to dry now because I want to doodle on top of them. I think I'm going to mute you guys for a second. Where did I put my heat gun? Oh, it's over there. I had to like pull my desk out to put all my canvases against the wall there, so... You're doing better. Not completely healed yet, but you're doing better. Better is good. Cords all under things. Okay. My chair does not like rolling here. Okay, heat gun alert. Where's my heat gun? Heat gun, there you are. And I'll mute you. Yeah, no, that's not Alice. It's the Red Queen. Congratulations, Susan. I've never heard of King Art, I don't think, but I assume... Are they the ones you fill with water, or do they already have, like, product in them? Yeah, this is my Red Queen. Tweedledee, Tweedledum, Red Queen. The Alice from earlier. This is the... Where's the Alice? My creepy dark Alice from earlier. There's my other Tweedledee and Tweedledum. This is the one from earlier in the stream. She's my creepy dark Alice. Her shoulders can still be darker. Karen Dash pencil box. Ink in them. Oh, 48. Cool. That'll be fun to play with. I'm just playing and experimenting with the bigger brush pen. Ew, Alice. Posture check. I don't have that window open, so I can't see it. I couldn't have too much open when I had a guest artist. But thank you for checking in. Definitely after 3 hours, posture check, hydrate. Everyone stretch, roll your shoulders. Don't know if I want to draw on her hair. I think I'll only do a few things with this pen. Her frills. Some of my pens just don't work. They don't work. I know, like, Merida hair, but crazy. I'm just scribbling. She's a wild
on a crazy gal. Oh yeah, she needs her lashes, doesn't she? Queen needs her lashes. That was wet. Ew, Queen needs her lashes. You like the scribbles? It was 2 weeks of learning to let go. That's pretty much what the course was. Let go. I thought I was pretty good at letting go, but I think I've progressed. She needs wilder lashes. She's gonna have the caterpillars. Not gonna be able to get them even, but there's too much white there. It's one crazy queen. You found out how scribbles are hard. They can be. They definitely can be. I need more black pens. I don't want to really scribble with my Jane ones because they cost a lot of money. I got one from Muji, but it's like oil based. I don't think it'll go through the paper. Oil based ink twin tip permanent marker black. Made in Japan. Oh. Alcohol solvents is used for this pen. Please ventilate when using for a long time. If it's alcohol, it will go through my paper. I'm not gonna use that. That James's way. If you want less control, hold it further back. Touch that. I kind of like her. Like the... The Red Queen. Not a Red Queen. The Red Queen. She needs a color in there, though. Like a gem that her heart is in. Should be like an emerald. There's no green anywhere else, though. I can do like scribbles over top of that. I think that looks good. You like her, Susan? And then our Tweedles. The Tweedles. I was gonna have them holding something, but I don't know what. So I didn't draw anything there yet. That's what I was saying, a tree bag, like, but he's already, like, should it just be a bag? Because he's already got a little pumpkin on his patch. He's got a pumpkin on a patch. Pumpkin patch. That's funny. I didn't even... It was not on my radar. Get it? Because pumpkins grow in patches. Could say like trick or treat on it, right? So if we did,
pretty small treat bag. I should have done it bigger, but I did not. And then we're going to have to color it. I think it needs to be brown. Brown. Oh yeah, a little skull would have been cool. That's what I did on my swatch dolls. They had a little skull bag. Patiently wait for the ink to dry. Then I give it a quick blast of the heat gun. Kind of covering almost all of it because there was like green and blue behind it. And you don't want green and blue behind it. Stamp it out. See, now the story can be like their bag is so small, so they're eyeing each other up to make sure that nobody steals. The other one doesn't steal any candy out of the bag. Because they have to share. They have to share that tiny little bit. I just put my finger in the paint. Blue, anyone? Which pen works? Oh, you liked my handbook for the recently deceased? Yeah, I didn't want to do it exactly like the cover, so that's why I was like, who else can I put in there on the cover? It's like, yes. Lydia Dietz from Beetlejuice. I would like it. Oh, I think it's done. I think. No, I need a few more scribbles. Scribble touches now. You've unleashed Tim Burton monsters, James. You have. I was already doing Tim Burton before, but it's gonna be a whole new ballgame now.
stomach's growling. You can go on and on and on and on and on and on and on. My stomach's totally grumbling because I ate lunch like so early before the stream. I've been on here for over 3.5 hours now. Because we had about 15, 20 minutes of trying to get the stream going, so we had a hard time getting her into the video. Yeah. Yes, a little longer than my normal 2 hours. How? Well, like, Olga, who I had in the stream, she said that she's subscribed to me a few times on YouTube, and for some reason it keeps unsubscribing her. So I don't know if there's, like, different glitches going on. You're on Twitch, though, right now. That's weird. Is that where you're getting the notifications, or are you getting them on a different platform? Huh. Yeah, because you've been coming in late a lot lately, and then maybe Diana's not getting them either, because most of the time now she's not here, and then she messages me and tells me how she missed it. I missed it again. So I don't know. These algorithm things. Interesting. We could really take this different when doing the shading with scratching. Like to show like her nostrils, her bridge, her nose bridge. I think I've pushed her a little too far now.
I was just thinking, because I started doing this, and I was thinking about how we did the cascading kind of scribbles outside of Lydia Dietz. I was saying those would be cool around the eye. Kind of are. I need to turn it back on. Well, I've done that when I wanted to watch like a Tim Holtz or something on Saturday. It's like, oh my gosh, he starts at 10. It's like 11:30. Dark now. Now her eyes stand apart from everything else in her face. I think I pushed her too far. Oh my gosh. When you push it too far, what do? You tie it in. Think the pen tied. Almost. You like it, Gypsy? Your crown's too clean. Oh, that's doing it. That's bringing it back. To wet. Okay. I do need to do something with that inside of that. Maybe my other brush will work. Even though it's still... What?
We could do that at all. No. Swirls. A few more little circles around their mouths, if this will work. $3.33, make a wish. Okay. I think 3.5 hours of streaming is good. I need to go see my family now. This crazy bat Marco should be done work. That's just... that's bonkers. That's bonkers. Look at that. I'm going to screenshot it. Well, sorry about that. So I can post it in James Burke's group. Where did I grab? Where is it? I had my little business card. Oh well. Screen capture. Thank you for joining me, you guys. We can do this again on Friday. Friday will be the regular time at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And if you guys have seen any of these little creatures at the toy store and you see one on clearance, it's good to get. This is what I'm going to be teaching my kids in the upcoming class that starts next week for eyebrows and eyelids, like how changing them, like even if you didn't see his mouth, how they can change the expression. Look at that. That's what your eyebrows and eyelids can do in your art. So he was in the clearance bin, so I grabbed him. But yes. So thank you guys for joining me. I hope you had fun. I apologize for the glitches earlier, and I apologize to poor Olga, because that was not my plan. My plan was for us to like hang out for 2 hours. Let's see if I can share her links again there, and have some fun. But we will try it again. I believe next time we do it, we'll be on her platform again, because we alternate. That's the deal we've decided to do. But yes, so thank you for joining me. I hope you guys had fun. I hope you were inspired. And I hope you go create something. And as always, 15 minutes. Minimum 15 minutes of kitchen dancing or Susan's recovering. Any kind of dancing you can do. I want you to crank your favorite tunes. I want you to sing your little hearts out. And I want you to groove however you can, because it's good for the body, mind, and soul. And you need to fill your buckets. So take care of yourselves, and I will see you all very soon on Friday. Thanks for hanging out with me. See you soon. Bye-bye for now.